What's good, YouTube? Knifey Sam here, back again, once again. And today, people, today, I'm going on a trip. I'm going to UK Nationals. Not actually on the day I'm recording this right now, but you will see that trip in this video. I would have liked to have been more active on social media this year, but work has just been absolutely mental, busy. I've been working 6 days a week, sort of 50 hours some weeks. It's been pretty crazy. I'm out here where I work at the moment, so this is the throwing range. I haven't spent too much time here, as much time as I probably would have liked, especially with a competition coming up. Spent most of my time down on the river teaching stand-up paddle boarding. Today is my last day of proper practice, getting all my techniques down before I travel up to, well, Chesterfield, Mansfield area. So I think it's closer to Mansfield, the actual place. But I'll be recording my trip, documenting it. Just thought I'd record a little intro day before, because a few things I've been thinking of going around in my head about what sort of techniques I'm going to use, and I'm just going to sort of explain some of those right now. So in the knife throwing, in rotational, I believe you throw from 3 meters, 5 meters, and 7 meters, which doesn't necessarily mean one rotation, two rotations, three rotations, I don't think. Unless there are specific rules on that. So this is my first time competing, so I'm gonna find out. I'm gonna see what everyone else is doing, and next year I'll be more prepared. So I'm not expecting too much from myself this year. I do want to at least win, let's say one category, at least, no spin throwing, or maybe one of the games, like quick draw, snipe. I don't know. I don't know. That's I'm being ambitious. I want to win something. But tomahawk rotation, from what I've seen, it's 4 meters, 5 meters, 7 meters. So you do one rotation from 4 meters, again, all well and good. 5 meters. Now, are they expecting you to throw 1.5 rotations, which I can do? That's perfectly fine. But I could also use my thumb on the example here. I could also use my thumb to slow down the rotation a little bit and still throw one rotation from 5 meters, which again I've been practicing and it works. So hang on, standing at 5 meters here at my target. Use that thumb and just miss the target is pretty much what you're going to do there. I've literally not thrown anything today. Need a few warm-up throws to get into it. Right, where are we at? 5 meters. Use the thumb. Focus less on the camera, more on the target. And there you go. It goes in. Even slightly under-rotated, if anything. And then 7 meters, that will be two rotations. That's my standard two rotation throw from 7 meters, which is fine. Which is about here, seven. And yeah, that's completely fine. There's been different quick draw techniques I've been trying as well. I'm not sure if you can choose your technique or if you have to use a specific technique. There's lots of questions that I've got. I'm just gonna go and wing it and just see how I do, pretty much. So. I'll leave tomorrow. Registration's tomorrow. Registration opens at 9 a.m. I've been told I latest 7 p.m. Because I'm traveling. It's going to take, I don't know how long it's going to take, over 3 hours probably, to get myself up to the Chesterfield area. So I'm having a night out tonight as well. It's my Thursday. I do not miss a Thursday night out. I do not. So it's Thursday night out tonight, and then traveling, hoping to leave around lunchtime. So I'm not going to drink too much. I'm not going to be too hungover. I'm going to be okay to drive up and register on the Friday, and then the competition starts on the Saturday. So hopefully get a little bit of practice on registration tomorrow as well. Again, I'm not too sure. I don't know what to expect. My first competition. But wish me the best of luck. I'm going to get my last practice in today. Yesterday's practice felt good. Day before practice didn't feel good at all. Just one of those days, nothing was going right. But I think I've started to get my techniques down, and today is the day to perfect my techniques, work on my accuracy a little bit more. And I've been rambling on for 6 minutes now, which is interesting for me, being not much of a chatterbox, but there you go. But yeah, I'm gonna dip out now for today, get my practice in, and I will see you in a couple of seconds, which will be tomorrow. Okay, good morning. This is a travel day. I'm not hungover. I took it easy last night. Had about six cans of cider, two gin and lemonades, and a shot of sour. So plenty of food, plenty of water. Woken up, and I'm fine. A little bit tired, but there you go. Now the journey's looking like over 3 hours. That could turn into 4 hours, depending on traffic and things. But yeah, I've never actually driven this far before, so that's going to be an experience as well, driving over 3 hours down the motorway. But yeah, we'll see how it goes. So I didn't do much talking to the camera whilst I was up there, so it's just going to be me talking over clips that I've recorded throughout the weekend. So it took about 4 hours to get up there, so really bad journey. Well, once I got there, about 4:30, I met John. First time meeting John, awesome guy. Went through everything with me, what to expect, and then I got myself down onto the training range where I got my training in and met some of the throwers, some of the competitors. Again, really friendly people. After I got my training in, we went to the pub where we're staying in. So it's called a New Inn in Newton. So it's a pub with a few rooms connected to it. And on the Friday night, they had a karaoke, which, yeah, it was good fun, as you will see.
I'm still standing better than I ever did. Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. I'm still standing.
Okay, so Saturday morning, I was up nice and early. I was the first one down onto the training range, get my practice in. There's my girlfriend Bex. Shout out to Bex who came up with me. Okay, so here we are competing on the Saturday. Here are some clips from my axe throwing. Looks like we're back at 7 meters here on this one. I didn't do too bad in the axes. Luckily, Bex didn't record any of my knife throwing. My rotational knife game is really bad at the moment. I am definitely in need of some better rotational knives, which I'm going to be sorting out soon enough. Actually, a bad throw there as well. But yeah, I didn't do too bad in the axes. I actually came 16th out of 80 overall, which I was quite happy with. Like I say, accuracy isn't something I normally practice. It's got a nice 5 on that one. Looks like a 3 on that one. And on this next one, not a great throw either. Okay, and that brings us to the end of the day here in this clip. I did compete in everything throughout the day. I took part in all the games. I did the rotational knife throwing, axe throwing, did silhouettes knife, all that good stuff. And this is about almost 8 o'clock here. I think we were here until later than 8 o'clock. It was a long day. I was not expecting it to be so long. These days, yeah, I say it was late nights, early mornings. It was a very tiring trip. After my week off, I feel like I need another week off to recover. Okay, so Saturday night was a bit of a quieter night, and they had some live music here at the pub. We didn't stay as long, and there wasn't as many people there anyway. Took it easier on the drinks and was ready and prepared to be up on Sunday. Okay, and that brings us to Sunday. Now, I was the first on the training range again on the Sunday. I was the first out in the morning on both days. I was up, I was ready, even though we were out drinking both nights. I was determined to win something. So here I am competing in no spin throwing, and I massively bottled this. I was hoping for a medal. This is my one chance. I thought I was going to medal in something. I thought it was going to be this. But it wasn't. I do end up finishing fourth in no spin throwing. I just massively bottled it. It's one of those things. If you don't perform when it comes down to it, then you're not going to medal. So better luck next year. I'm going to be training extra hard for next year because I want a no spin throwing medal for next year.
So Sunday was a bit quieter. I competed in no spin throwing. Just before the no spin, I did do some double bit axe throwing, which I'd never done before. So I got one of the worst scores out of everyone that competed in it, which is great. Again, another thing to think about for next year, something I should maybe buy a double bit, do some practice. And then after this, we had quick draw, and then we had long distance knife throwing. So on to the quick draw clips. Okay, so quick draw. I set a good enough time to come into the top 16, and here's my quarterfinal playoff. It's best of three, first round, and we both missed. That happened quite a lot between quite a lot of the throwers. You're trying to go too quick, and you just absolutely fuck it up. But here we go, round two, orange, amber, sorry, and green. I just about got there before he did. And the third round, we actually both missed again. So I do take the win on this one and then lose in the top eight in this quarterfinal rounds after this. So that first clip was quite funny. My opponent landed his shot, and mine skipped off the top of my target and landed into the backboards behind the other targets. We both miss both of our knives on the next throws, so my opponent takes a win on this one, and I come in the top eight. Okay, now on to long distance throwing. Here is the knife throwing. This first throw here was from 3 meters, I believe. And then you'll see the two rotation, three rotation, and so on. Now, I actually medal in this somehow, which is a complete shithousery. After sort of 3 meters, I was like completely winging it. There are some people there. David Mitchell, who had their distances written down on a piece of paper. So they knew where to stand for their most comfortable throwing spot. I literally just picked a random spot in the box and threw my knives. Made sure I hit the target and then just hope they go in. On the free rotation, you'll see I throw one, doesn't go in, slightly adjust, doesn't go in, slightly adjust again, and I do get it in. And the four rotation is just a complete guess, which I believe is this next throw here, my opponent there. Going out on the third round, and this one completely random. I managed to get the first one, and the winning throw, our silver medal winning throw, was also just awful throw, but it counted, and I somehow come back with a medal, which I was pleased with. Disappointed with my performance in the long distance axe. I should have been a lot better at long distance axe, because I do throw long distance axe practicing quite a lot sometimes. But yeah, hey ho, it is what it is. This is how the competition goes. If you don't make it when it's your time, then tough luck. You got to go again next year, which we will be. We'll come back stronger next year. But I'm going to let the rest of this clip play now. I think actually that one was my last throw. It's just in the black, well, on the black circle, sort of top left, massively over rotated there. And my last throw doesn't go in. So I'm going to let the clip play out. And then I'm not sure what clips after this, you'll get to see it. Okay, and that's it. That was the end of UK Nationals. I came away with a medal, very happy. And now on the way home, we stop off in Nottingham. Here's my night out in Nottingham, if anyone's interested. This morning. Okay, so in Nottingham, we did a few things. We went and saw the Robin Hood statue, stood outside the castle. This is the oldest pub in the UK, which was built into the side of the castle. We then went and did the Robin Hood experience, which was an experience. A little bit naff, I guess, but it was fun. We had a good time trying on a few little costumes and whatnot. It was cool. It was something to do. Nottingham, you did all right. It's not the worst place I've been to.
It looks like
you've done a heavy ride. Okay, so there we have it, back in Bristol. What a weekend. Been to a new place, met lots of new people that throw, which is not something I get down here in Bristol. There's not many places to do this sort of thing. Obviously I'll work at one just here. Hopefully we can become a catter range. We do need a more professional setup, in my opinion, so that's the next task, getting on to my boss about building proper competition targets, because some of these need replacing anyway. This one is absolutely battered. This one is just massive. So we do need a better setup. So hopefully we can become a better center. We've got the land and the targets, hopefully one day. But yeah, so I've just watched my video back of the at the beginning. Clip of this video, just because I didn't know what I said. Like, I just really didn't know what to expect. I did come back with a medal, which is what I was hoping for. I was being ambitious with that as well, because the level is high. The level is quite high. I came back with silver in distance knife throwing, which was a bit of a shithousery, because I just completely winged it. Doesn't feel like a proper medal. There are some people, I think it was David Mitchell, he had his distances written down on a piece of paper for each step back. And I just went to the guy who was measuring me after three rotations. I don't know my distance, I'm just gonna wing it. I literally just stood through and just got lucky, got it in. But at least hitting the target's one thing, getting rotations the other. So if you hit the target, you give yourself a chance at the end of the day. But yeah, came back with silver in distance knife throwing. Disappointed to come fourth in no spin throwing. That was the one I was looking forward to all weekend, the one I was most confident in, and I completely bottled it. I could have done better. I should have got into the medals. Completely bottled it though. I just got frustrated. I couldn't calm myself down. I did calm myself down sort of too late, sort of halfway through on like the third or fourth round. I think the third round I had my best score. But just completely bottled it. So we go again next year. I will be back next year, and I want to medal in no spin throw next year. I will be practicing a lot. Because I only missed out on the top three by like 3 points. So there's one well-placed knife missed me, and I wasn't too far off silver either. So a couple of those knives. That's how it is. It just comes to on the day, can you do it? Can you keep your composure, keep your nerve? And I just didn't. Other than that, I came quarterfinals in the Dual Cup, which I was happy with. Top eight. I'll take it. Again, quick draw isn't something that I practice. And then what else did I do? I came 16th overall in the axe throw, 16th out of 80 in axes, which again I'm quite happy with. Accuracy isn't something that I normally work on, which it is something I'm going to work on from now on, because if you see my other videos, it's mainly trick shots and just doing crazy things with the axes. It's never just standing there and trying to hit the middle. So in future, again, when I'm on here on my days off practicing, I will be practicing more accuracy and trying to work on that, and maybe push into the top 10 for next time. That's what I want to get to. I want to get into top 10 for the axe throwing, so I go into the finals for that. And then my rotational knife throwing needs to improve massively. I don't expect to challenge anywhere near any of those guys next year in rotational knife throwing. Though I am going to hit up George for a few sets, or a set at least, of his knives, because I think I need it. The knives I were using were like 40 quid Gilhibben knives, so I'm going to need to upgrade my my rotational knife throwing knives. Maybe sell some of my no-spin throwing knives, because I did buy another set off Andy whilst I was there, which were really good. They felt really good. I think they're probably my new favourite set once I get more used to them. And yeah, so that's it. That's my weekend. You've seen more than just throwing in this video. You've probably seen the karaoke clips. You've seen the nights out in Nottingham. Yeah, it's been one hell of a weekend. Tiring, like late nights, early mornings. I'm pretty sure a lot of other people were doing that. We stayed in a pub, so. But yeah, to sum all that up, fucking brilliant weekend. I can't wait to do it again next year. I definitely will be there next year. Unless something happens to me, unless my arm falls off, I will definitely be there. I will see you all again next year. And I will see you all again next year. All right, peace.